The placenta is a temporary organ that undergoes a natural process of aging, known as senescence. It is programmed to age and change over its 9-month lifespan. This process progresses throughout pregnancy. Forming partly from the fertilized egg and the embryo cells, and partly from the mother's uterine lining, this joint effort is the only organ built by two individuals, designed to connect them, working together to sustain a new life. It develops only after conception and functions like multiple organs combined. The placenta acts like the fetus's lungs, exchanging oxygen and carbon dioxide. It works like the kidneys, removing waste products. It functions like the liver, processing nutrients. And it even acts as an endocrine gland, producing several hormones such as HCG, progesterone, estrogens, and HPL, all essential for the fetus to grow and develop. The placental membrane is where the exchange of substances happens between the mother and the fetus. By secreting a wide range of hormones, this powerful endocrine organ regulates almost every major maternal system to ensure the baby's survival. During implantation, the placenta remodels the mother's spiral arteries, transforming them into wide, low-resistance vessels that can deliver a large, steady flow of blood to the fetus. After implantation, it produces massive amounts of progesterone and estrogen, which keeps the uterine lining thick and healthy while preventing premature contractions. The placenta also alters the mother's metabolism to prioritize the delivery of nutrients and energy to the fetus. Human placental lactogen, HPL, is a hormone made by the placenta and released into both maternal and fetal circulations. In the mother, it alters metabolism to keep more glucose and amino acids in the blood, ensuring a steady supply of nutrients for the baby. For the fetus, HPL supports growth, regulates metabolism, and aids in organ development, including lung maturity. To support these demands, the placenta signals the body to increase blood volume by nearly 50%. The mother's heart responds by pumping harder, raising her cardiac output. The placenta also acts as an immune buffer. It prevents the mother's immune system from rejecting the fetus, which carries the father's genes, by creating a state of immune tolerance at the maternal-fetal interface. The placenta naturally matures as pregnancy progresses around 36 to 40 weeks. It naturally undergoes microscopic changes, including small calcium deposits, tiny dead spots, and a reduction in surface area for exchange, a process known as senescence. This is usually harmless if the baby is already full term. This aging is actually a normal part of its life cycle and is thought to play a role in the timing of labor and attachment. The placenta's functional life essentially comes to an end at birth. During childbirth, the placenta plays an active role in supporting a safe delivery. It releases hormones like relaxin, which loosen the ligaments and joints of the pelvis, creating more space for the baby to pass through the birth canal. The placenta is also designed to support the baby's nutrition after birth. It produces human placental lactogen, HPL, which stimulates the growth and development of the mother's mammary glands in preparation for breastfeeding. Once the baby is delivered, the placenta has completed its main role. Having functioned flawlessly throughout the full 9 months of pregnancy to support the baby's growth and the mother's health. After the umbilical cord is clamped and cut, the baby no longer relies on the placenta for oxygen and nutrients. The fetal circulation to the placenta essentially stops, causing the placenta to lose firmness and shrink slightly. At the same time, the uterus begins to contract and shrink dramatically. This reduces the implantation site, shearing the placenta away from the uterine wall. Continued contractions then push the placenta out through the birth canal, a process known as the third stage of labor, which usually occurs within 5 to 30 minutes after delivery. It is then expelled from the mother's body. Once outside the uterus, the placenta quickly loses its blood supply and can no longer function. It essentially dies at this point, becoming a piece of tissue with no further role. A temporary organ whose remarkable job is now complete. Now it is considered a waste tissue. After childbirth, the medical team carefully inspects the placenta to ensure it's been delivered completely. Normally, the entire placenta separates and comes out, but if a piece of placenta or membrane remains attached to the uterine wall, called retained placenta, the uterus cannot contract properly. This leaves blood vessels at the implantation site open, leading to heavy bleeding and postpartum hemorrhage. Retained tissue can also become a breeding ground for bacteria, causing infection that may result in serious and even life-threatening complications. For this reason, the delivered placenta should be carefully and thoroughly examined immediately after birth to confirm it is complete. Any suspected fragments must be removed promptly. If there were complications during pregnancy or delivery, the placenta may be sent to a pathology lab for further study. In some cultures, however, families choose to take the placenta home for burial, rituals, or special ceremonies. Otherwise, in most hospitals, the placenta is treated as biological medical waste. It's collected in a special container and then either incinerated or disposed of according to medical waste regulations.